Hello, and welcome to another episode of This Is My Architecture. I'm Sonika, and today I have Saket from Tally with me. Hello, Saket.
Hi, Sonika. Thank you for having me here today.
Thanks for giving us your time, Saket. Can you tell us a bit about Tally?
Yeah, Tally is the business management software that has enabled 7 million users across 2 million small and mid-sized businesses across the world for their accounting, inventory, and payroll functions. During the last 35 years, we've been in the business domain. We've always created technology and products that adapts to the way our customers run their businesses.
What is TallyPrime on AWS?
TallyPrime on AWS is based on our current architecture, which is TallyPrime. We are taking an enterprise-grade Windows desktop application and putting it on the cloud for at scale for our customers. We're also building our next generation technology architecture, which is cloud native and which will set new industry benchmarks.
That's nice. You spoke about 2 million SMBs, right?
Yeah.
And that's like a big scale.
Yeah.
So why don't you talk us, how are you managing that scale with TallyPrime on AWS?
Sure. So our secret ingredient for scale has been this concept of what we call as the multi-AWS account architecture. We have different types of AWS accounts. And as we scale, we are able to add new AWS accounts with new VMs and scale in an unlimited manner. If I were to draw an analogy to data center design, then the shift from vertical computing, vertical scaling to horizontal scaling is the analogy we would see. So earlier people used to have a lot of vertical servers and now they've shifted to pizza box styled one use servers in the data center racks. Similarly, what we have here is an account, which is what we're referring to as the customer pod account. So this is a customer pod account, which consists of 1,000 VMs. So as we scale, we just add more and more these pizza boxes, and we're able to scale to an unlimited number.
So AWS multi-account structure is your secret for scalability.
Yeah.
So that's great. Why don't you talk about security? Because you're using TallyPrime on AWS for accounting, and I'm sure security is important.
Absolutely, security is paramount when it comes to Tally. Customer financial data, security and privacy is paramount. So in addition to the standard data at rest and data in transit, what we have here is the admin account. So this is the admin account. In the admin account, we have this concept, innovative concept of dual authentication for the customer. When the user logs in through a web browser or through a thick client, they land up at the login API, which is effectively API gateway endpoint, which is backed by a Lambda, which would then authorize the concept of dual authentication is internally we'll first authenticate, and then it would, if that authentication is successful, it will send it for a second level authentication to tally.net backend, where the second level of authentication would happen. And once this is done, it would return a secret token. So this is in conjunction with the CMK of KMS. If the authentication is successful, then a security token is returned back to the user, and which can then be used to connect to the customer pod account.
That's great. So once the user receives the token, Saket, how does the user use the token to use TallyPrime on AWS?
Yeah, that's a very interesting question. So once the token has arrived at the user end, that is passed through NICE DCV. So we are using NICE DCV as a high-performance desktop remoting solution. It's a very important ingredient for the overall solution because it is zero cost and enterprise support. Mm-hmm. Additionally, it has the flexibility to allow us to connect through browsers as well as thick clients. So using a browser or a thick client, so NICE DCV allows us to use either of the two solutions. The customer request is routed to CloudFront over the internet. At the CloudFront, we are also using Lambda at Edge. So the Lambda at Edge at CloudFront would then route it to the correct ALB because we have this large scale, right? So we have multiple ALBs, and the ALB would then route it to the right container. So this is effectively a single ECS cluster running on EC2, and we are then routing and landing at the correct container. Just one thing to point out about the previous admin account, once the request is landed to the container, it would do an authentication back with the authorizing Lambda.
Oh, so this is a really great journey, user interaction, and then that's how we get TallyPrime on AWS, right? The virtual office to the user.
Yeah.
So once the virtual office is there, right, it is also the simplicity, right? And Tally is known for power of simplicity.
Yeah.
Can you also talk about how are you managing power of simplicity with this architecture?
Absolutely. So if you forget about all this complexity, right, this technical mumbo jumbo, what does the end user care about? So the end user wants a virtual office with the virtual computers. That is exactly what we're delivering. We are able to deliver the used to working at Tally on their laptop or desktop. Now we are giving that exact same experience in a virtual computer that is hosted in the cloud. So the end users and customers don't have to worry about this complexity, and they're getting exactly what they're used to, the same Tally interface, the same features, everything is identical.
Oh, wow. Now we started with 2 million SMBN users, and that's why TallyPrime on AWS is created.
Yeah.
I'm sure cost is really important, right? Because this is for SMBs. Can you talk about how are you managing cost with this architecture, Saket?
Yeah, that's an extremely valid, you know, very important question, because we have obsessed very hard about optimizing costs here. We're talking about SMBs of India, right? We're not talking about large companies. So how do we optimize the cost is absolutely essential. In fact, that made the project much more harder to implement. Had it not been the cost factor, we could have made decisions which were simpler to implement, but we couldn't. One of the primary ways we have controlled the cost is we are running the entire thing on Linux as opposed to Windows to control the costs that are associated with software licensing. Additionally, we are using the Docker containerization using ECS, and that allows us to squeeze the most out of the virtual hardware that we've got. And during the initial design, we chose AMD instances over Intel's instances. That had also helped us with significant savings.
Saket, thank you so much for giving us time today and explaining how TallyPrime on AWS runs.
Thank you for having me, Sonika.
Thank you for watching. This is My Architecture.